I remember vividly how a Chimane folk healer in the depths of the Amazon once told me that the forest I saw was not the same he knew. Where I could only see trees, birds, and rivers, he could see a universe made up of stories, dreams, and the whispering of the ancestors. Trees were not only trees for him, but rather active sentient beings filled with spirits, memories, and history. Through his teachings, I learned to see the Amazon not just as a landscape, but more broadly as a storyscape, a repository of stories and songs that have been handed down from generation to generation. As a researcher working in the Amazonian rainforest, I was appalled by the huge wildfires scorching the Amazon. The magnitude of the catastrophe made me think a lot about the stories that we tell about the Amazon and its enduring social imaginaries. We always portray the Amazon as an exotic realm of jaguars, exuberant vegetation, and majestic kapok trees. A pristine Garden of Eden, devoid of the destructive impacts of people. What often clashes with me is that such idealized vision of the Amazon often excludes other ways of seeing and understanding nature, particularly those of the people who call the rainforest home.
The Amazon really should be seen as a cultural space. It's the home for its indigenous peoples, and it's been their home for thousands of years. It embeds lots of history in the cultural landscape.
Yeah, it's not a pristine environment where humans don't play a role. Quite on the contrary, humans have played a very significant role in shaping what is Amazonia today.
We co-construct the environment through language, through the breath, through invisible actions like blowing, visualizing that seem to be irrelevant, but actually they play a big role in the co-construction of the environment.
All these years, I've been trying to show through my research that some of the best conserved forest ecosystems in the Amazon have been actively shaped by indigenous peoples over millennia. Mobilizing many cartographic resources and satellite imagery, we have been able to show that the future of the Amazon's biodiversity lies in the hands of indigenous peoples. Through advanced geospatial analysis, we are managing to bring global recognition to the unique contributions of indigenous peoples, not only in safeguarding the world's largest standing rainforest, but also in maintaining the fabric of life on which humanity depends. The best research ideas I've had have always emerged sitting around the fire and sharing stories. There's no doubt that storytelling is part of our shared ancestry, and it is woven into our ancient fabric. Science is yet another story, one that furthers our understanding of the world around us, one that could enshrine and connect the vast constellations of stories that explain the ebb and flow of nature, and people's place within that flow. In these days we live in, there is a greater need than ever to tell better stories. Stories that will shape the world for future generations.